All right, let's see. Let's investigate. What do we got? Oh, it's a rolling bucket. That's what you heard, you old man. You heard the rolling bucket. What's up, guys? It's Ryantium here, and today we are back in Skyrim, and oh snap, is it going to be an awesome freaking day? But first, if you guys enjoy what you're about to see, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe for more daily videos, and if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter at CouchPotato1898. Link is down there in the description. So, today, guys, I am so freaking excited to get started with this new mod. So, last episode and the episodes before that, we were doing the Forgotten City questline, and that quest was amazing! The mod itself was so amazing. I got so much out of that. It was such an amazing experience. I loved playing it, and I hope you guys enjoyed seeing it, because today, guys, we are starting on a journey that is going to be, in my opinion, so much longer than the Golden City one. So, the Golden City adds about, or not the Golden City, the Forgotten City. The Forgotten City adds about 6 to 8, maybe 10 hours worth of gameplay, depending on how many times you do the endings, how many people you talk to, all sorts of that stuff. But this quest, guys, this mod is called FALSKAAR. Now, I have seen FALSKAAR demoed by Cam and Seb, the guys who used to do top 5 Skyrim mods of the week. I watched them do this mod for a Christmas special probably, what, 3 years ago? 3 or 4 years ago? Hell, it might have even been more. But FALSKAAR is huge, guys. 614.83 megabytes, 20 to 30 hours of gameplay, 26 quests, 17 side quests, 9 main story quests, new spells, shouts, weapons, armor, soundtrack containing 21 brand new tracks composed by Adam Couvert just for FALSKAAR, adding more than 60 minutes of new music. That's incredible! And it's all fully voiced by featuring almost 30 semi-professional and professional voice actors and actresses. So, we're in for a major quest line here, guys, and I'm super pumped about it. So, without further ado, let's get this ball rolling. So, I need to talk to someone inside of Riften. Here he is! What's up, Jalimar?
Huh? Yeah?
Yeah, are you alright, sir?
Huh? Well, not really.
What seems to be the matter? What's wrong?
Well, I was taking an evening walk like I always do, and I saw some men outside the Echo Deep Mine.
Okay.
The thing is, they look like mercenaries, up to no good.
Well, I'll take care of them. What makes you say that?
I've never seen them around here, and they look real tough. In addition, the Echo Deep Mines are not a place people go. There are myths about it.
Myths, you say?
All sorts of stories. Some say it's haunted by ghosts. Some say a wealthy bandit lord hides out in it, quietly contributing to the crime in Riften.
Huh.
Some people even say that deep within the mines there are Dwemer ruins, full of all sorts of automatons, just waiting to slay whoever enters.
Well, we don't like those, so what's the problem?
On my way back from my walk, I passed the mine entrance again. I heard all sorts of horrific noises. I reckon something happened to those men.
It's the White Walkers.
Anyone going to those mines is up to no good. Now, I've asked a guard to take a look, but they just ignore me. I need someone to see what's happened.
So you want me to do it? Yep, he does.
Please, if they're planning something, the city guard needs to know. Please, go check for me.
Okay. Sure, I'll take a look.
Finally, thank you. I'll mark it down on your map. Just be careful. We still don't know what's in there.
Oh, God. Okay, so, good. We have a waypoint, an ancient gate. Ooh. So, I wanted to let you guys know that I had to uninstall about 10 mods in my whole entire mod list. I'm going to go through and update it in the description, so if you want to see the ones that I'm playing with, you'll be able to see that. But, as you can hear, some of you I'm sure can tell, this is not the regular Skyrim music. I finally got that mod back in, guys, because the mod author, it got taken down for some reason, and then he put it back up, he or she put it back up, so I'm pretty thankful that they put it back up. But yeah, we got the music mod back, so it adds the music from Elder Scrolls Online, Morrowind, Oblivion, and then Skyrim. So it's a pretty neat mod. I love that mod so much. But some of the mods that I had to uninstall were the Forgotten City. I had to uninstall some of the player homes that I've showcased in the past. I had to uninstall a couple of the weapon mods. And then I think that's pretty much all the mods that I had to uninstall. Not too bad. We pretty much already finished all the mods that I had deleted. So that's why I deleted them. But alright, so we need to head over to this mine, and I'm kind of curious to know if this is like the start of the quest, or if there's a couple quests before you get in there. What the hell was that? It sounded like a bear. It might have been a bear. Alright, so it looks like it's right around the corner. Oh jeez, it was a bear! Holy god! Scared the absolute living hell out of me. I'm gonna go and take this money. Thank you for your money. Taking your money. Alright, wonderful. Perfect. Where is the entrance? Looks like it's right there. Is it above me or below me? Below me. No, I'm sorry. That was bad. Echo Deep Mine. Okay. Let's go ahead and get a save in, just in case. I'm going to start saving instead of quick saving. I don't know why. Just a superstition of mine. Open Echo Deep Mine. Wonderful. Okay, so he said something about bandits and, like, mercenaries and stuff like that, and he said he heard horrific noises. That's not a good sign. Alright, let's see. Let's investigate. What do we got? Oh, it's a rolling bucket. That's what you heard, you old man. You heard the rolling bucket. Alright, let's see. Ooh, I'm afraid. I don't know what to expect from this mod, guys, nor this quest. I don't know what to expect, and that's what I love. Oh, Jesus Christ! God dang it, bro. You can't sneak up on a guy like that. You almost gave me a damn heart attack. Okay, perfect. Got some gold from her. God, that was terrifying. You know, I'm actually going to be pretty happy, though, with this new quest mod. Because in the Forgotten City, you couldn't really kill anybody because of Dwarves' Law. But now, now it's at my discretion. All right, let's see. Retire someday, get myself an island? Holy God. You got some pretty good ambitions there, buddy. Sorry about your bad luck there, sweetheart. You too, sweetie. Let's go ahead and kill them. Goodbye. Goodbye. Perfect. Oh, here comes another one. Here comes your friends. And they're all in Sovngarde now. Wow, that arrow almost hit me. You suck, dude. You're a really terrible shot. You know that, right? I'm sorry about your bad luck there, buddy. All right, what do we got through? Oh, I thought I saw a spider. I'm pretty much paranoid. Chitin helmet. Whoa, I don't have one of those. That's pretty nifty. No, I'm not wasting my damn time opening no damn chest. Ain't nobody got time for that. Oh, hi. Hello there, sir. Look at your face mask. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, buddy. I didn't mean to. Actually, I did. I'm sorry. I'm actually not sorry. All right, so this is a silver ore mine. So that's kind of nifty. I guess I'll come here if I ever need silver. God, this mine is freaking expansive, bro. You look like a dark... Why are you not wearing clothes? Oh, she is. She's just wearing kind of a... She's wearing a fox around her boobs. Okay, this guy knows I'm here. Oh, I'm sorry. Ah, there goes your head. Oh, my God. Oh, I thought that was the chief. Well, that's a long maul, isn't it? Let's see. Steel maul, yep. All right, let's go ahead and feed on him. I need to feed. I need to feast. I'm pretty sure my last feeding was like... Oh, I don't know. Like... 100 hours, like, I'll go in game time or something like that. I have zero clue, but I just know I need to eat. So let's see. I hear another person down there swinging a pickaxe. Are you playing some Minecraft? You playing some Minecraft, sir? Hi. Oh my god. I just love sneaking up behind people and just killing them. It's awesome. I think that's the start of a serial killer, but oh well. All right, so let's see. Let me go ahead and find my way to the waypoint, guys, and then we're gonna go from there. Oh wait, no. Looks like we just go up here. Perfect. I didn't even need to kill those guys. See, I could have spared their lives, but I didn't. Oh wait, no. I'm going the wrong way. You damn moron. Maybe I did have to kill them. Yeah, I did have to kill them. Unless there's a way north or up. I don't know if there's a way up. Oh wait, what about through here? Did I already go through here? I don't think I did. No, I did not. Oh, God. I almost rolled right into him. Be careful. I'm not... Mother Trucker, I just killed you, and you're going to yell, "Be careful," as your last words? Okay, hello, dwarven stuff. Okay. Is that the bandit chief right there? I bet you it is. He's wearing a cape. Yep, she's the bandit chief. Sorry! Oh my god. Okay, well, let's go ahead and feed on her as well. Just get some more power! Give me the power! God, I never realized how freaking massive that sword was. Like, hot diggity damn. Alright, let's see. We got anything good? Nope, nothing too good. Alright, so we're in the Dwarven Ruins area. What do we got inside of here? Oh my god! What the shit?! What? Look at all this stuff! I'll take it. I'll just take it all. It's whatever. Bandit Chief's Journal, huh? Ooh. Evening. Earlier today, a group of young men paid us a handsome fee to let them through the mines into the Dwemer area below. I was more than happy to oblige. Oops, sorry, hit the wrong button. But I couldn't imagine what they would want down there. I thought we were tough for coming this close to the ruins, but they went right inside. They've already been down there for hours. They're probably dead. Late night, we were woken up by several loud screams and crashes from below. We heard the clatter of metal on metal and loud mechanical grinding noises. The sounds continued for several minutes before ceasing abruptly. I can only imagine what went on down there. Some of the men wanted to leave, but I'll do no such thing. This cave is the perfect hideout for us. And I won't give it up just because of old myths and mysterious sounds. What could have killed those men? Search dresser. What do you got inside of here, huh? Oh, it's just Dwemer metal. Okay, so this is a Dwarven ruin, guys. I'm a little bit afraid. I hate the Dwarven ruins. You guys know how I feel about them. Anything down there that wants to kill me? Probably. Hopefully not. Damn, this is an expansive ruin. Like, hot damn. It's so big. That's what she said. I'm sorry. All right, what do we got through here? There's the damn M's and Z's and U's again. Wonderful. All right, let's head in. Okay, we are inside of the Dwarven Ruin now. I love how I said I was going to start saving, not quick saving, and I immediately quick saved. I guess it's just it's a reflex. Was that a dead body? No, it wasn't. Okay. Okay. Wonderful. So there is still things that are alive down here. Or there are still things that are alive down here. Wonderful. Oh, God. I hate Dwarven Ruins. Especially ones with M's and Z's and U's before them. How is one solitary tree growing inside of here? Is this Wally? It should be inside of a shoe. All right. Let's see. I'll take some of those health potions. Appreciate you. God knows if they're littering the previous corridors with health potions. I'll probably need them. Okay, we're heading way deeper than I ever wanted to. Giggity. What? A weakened centurion. Damn, they freaking beat that thing up. Sorry about your bad luck there, buddy. Oh god, don't hit me. I got you in your kneecap. Oh, that was his pelvis. I may have just castrated a Dwarven Centurion, so that's kind of awkward. Okay. Hello there. You look like Lydia. Did you know that? But you're a man, so you can't be Lydia. Alright, mercenary leader, what do we got? Ancient lexicon. I'll take that. Okay, figure out what the lexicon does. Mercenary's journal. After far too long of searching, we have finally found it. We have found the ancient lexicon, and may now travel through the gate. Oh! Perhaps it was luck. Perhaps it was fate. My family's work is no longer wasted, and I can fulfill my grandfather's wishes. We are heading to the old buried ruins of tomorrow. I have worked a deal out with the local bandit leader to grant us passage, though we must still watch our backs as they are not to be trusted. We found the gate! It was just where the book said it was. We are going to secure the area and examine it real fast, then attempt to use the cube. It appears to have a control manifold we can use. There is a large Dwarven Centurion here that looks intact, but it is either slumbering or dead as it has yet to make any sounds or movement. Skyalum even tapped it with his sword, and we are confident that it will not harm us. I just hope this thing works. Well, that was kind of a dumb idea to tap the Dwarven Centurion. You're real smart, aren't you? Okay, activate pedestal. Here we go, guys. What is this gonna do? Oh, whoa. That's straight out of Portal or something. Holy hot damn. Oh! What the crap? Oh my Jesus! Whoa. Oh, I'm afraid. Okay, let's go ahead and get a save in just in case. Okay. Whoa. What the crap? Here we go. What the crap is going on? Who the hell are you?
You there? Did you just come through that portal?
Yes, I did, mate. Yeah, I did. Who the hell are you?
But if you just came through that, then that would make you the Traveler, wouldn't it?
What is going on? Where in Oblivion am I?
You didn't bother to find out where that thing went before you jumped in, did you? You're in FALSKAAR.
Haha, they said it.
I'm going to assume you're from Skyrim.
What you doing? You're floating backwards, bro.
The portal working. My job would dictate that I arrest you right here and now. However, I'm in the middle of something important right now. If you give me a hand with it, afterwards you're free to go.
Sure, Olvir, I'll help you.
A Nord named Machias. He's the blacksmithing apprentice in the nearby town of Ember Creek. I assume that since he isn't in here, he's in the nearby cave. Unfortunately, I can also assume that that cave is full of bandits.
Oh, wonderful.
I'll still have to report your arrival to my superiors, but if you assist me, I'll say you were cooperative and helpful.
Well, I don't really have a choice. What can I say? No? You'll just, like, kill me.
These bars is out here, and it looks like your portal thing has shut off. Meaning, I'm the only one who can let you out.
I mean, those bars look pretty far apart. I could probably squeeze through there. Maybe cut off an arm or two. Okay, sounds fair.
All right. Let me lower these bars for you.
I appreciate that, Olvir. What a nice person. Watch him die. Oh god, that'd be terrible. Dwarven Centurion drops from the ceiling onto him. That would be terrible. All right.
Well, let's get moving. I don't want to waste any more time.
I appreciate that. Wonderful. Okay, so an ancient gate. So we are in FALSKAAR now. Oh, welcome to FALSKAAR. Okay, is this a door? Okay, there we go. Search Brittle Run Cave. Okay, guys, let's go ahead and make it through these dwarven ruins, and then I'll meet you guys on the other side, I suppose. Oh, it's snowing. Check that out. It's snowing. I love it. All right, Olvir, where are you at, buddy? It sounds like it's raining, but it is snowing. I can pretty much guarantee that it's snowing. So we're in the hold called Amber Hold. Oh, whoa, holy hell. Oh my god, there's a full map. Look at the size of this place. There's a castle right there. Wow, this is a big place. Oh my god, look at the freaking sheer size of this whole entire map. That is amazing. Oh, guys. We are going to be in here for a while. Oh, Jesus. Criminy. You know what? That is really, really loud. And I don't like the fact that it's snowing while raining. Let's see. Change weather. Clear. Perfect. Holy God, that's beautiful. Look at that. Okay, so why is it telling me to go back inside of here? Maybe I went out too fast and Olvir is inside and I have to talk to him again. I don't even know what's going on. But guys, I feel like we're going to be in this FALSKAAR quest for a long time.
Let's keep moving.
Okay, go through the door first, Olvir. Okay, good. So that was the problem. I guess I went out too fast. I pre-jacked and stuff like that. All right, so let's go ahead and walk through here. That's okay. What? Why are you apologizing? Because I walked into you? Or because you walked into me? What's going on, buddy? There was no need for an apology. Alright, let's go ahead and get a save in just in case. You know how skeptical I am. No. Thank you. Perfect. I've also been a little bit skeptical because I uninstalled like 6 or 7 mods. And so I'm a little bit afraid to know if like the load order is going to mess up or anything like that. Oh, it's raining again. Looks like this place is in perpetual rain. Alright, what do we got? Is this the cave? Riddle Run Cave. Alright, just a normal cave, you know, like you do. It's nothing too bad. Looks like I'm gonna be able to behead some bandits for my first taste of blood in FALSKAAR. Yeah, you have, Bandit Marauder. You're actually pretty garbage at your job if your job was to guard the entrance. Sucks to suck, now I'm gonna murder all your friends. Alright, let's murder some bandits. We'll be right back. Alright, looks like we got to the place. Is this Machias? It is Machias. Let's go ahead and wait for Olvir to come over here, because I'm sure he wants to interrogate him or something.
Get me out of here. The switch to open the cage is on the wall over there. I have important news for Agnar.
Agnar?
What is it? Are you alright?
The bandits, they're working for Ingvar. I overheard them talking. They're searching for something. That's why they kidnapped me.
Are you two brothers?
What are they searching for? What could you possibly know?
What could you possibly know?
They wanted to know about some key, and when they found I didn't know anything, they were in range. They were deciding what to do with me when you two showed up. Thank the Divines for that.
You are welcome. Their heads are now severed.
I'll have our friend here tell him. You go home and get some rest.
Thank you for saving me.
Yeah, I guess he wants to stay in there. Okay.
To the southeast. I'd go but have a patrol to keep, and Machias is rattled and needs to rest.
I understand.
Once you're there, find the Jarl Agnar in the main house. Tell him the bandits are working for Ingvar. It's imperative that he knows. He may also have a reward for you for delivering such important information.
I like the sound of that.
I'll lock the gate for you.
I appreciate it, mate. Speak with Jarl Agnar in Amber Creek. Okay, guys, we are getting somewhere with this. I can't feed on them, damn. We are definitely getting somewhere with this so far, and we've only been at this for 20 minutes. But the size of that map, like you saw it, that thing is huge. That's probably the size of what, maybe one or two, like, cities in Skyrim? Like, that's crazy. That's probably the size of, like, Solitude and Whiterun in one area, and it's a mod. I am so freaking excited to, like, see everything that this place has to offer. It's huge. Can you imagine the, like, adventures we're gonna have here? I'm so freaking pumped! God, and you know the best part about this? It's the same thing that I had with the Forgotten City. I know nothing. You know nothing, Jon Snow. No, but I know nothing about any of these mods and any of these quests. And so it's all new to me, guys. That's what I love about this. Because, like I've said before, I've dumped over 500 hours worth of time into Skyrim on 360. And now that I get to do it all over again, I can now make new adventures with these cool quest mods. It's gonna be crazy insane. Alright, he said something about unlocking the gate, but they're still in there, so I assume I might have to unlock it myself. Or I'll just open it up. Or not. Oh, open gate. Maybe if you pull the lever! I can't even pull the lever? Does the guy really need to pull this for me? I'm pretty sure I'm competent enough to pull one lever. I'm pretty sure. I carry a greatsword the size of probably three babies. So I'm pretty sure I'm okay to pull a lever, but I guess not. So let's go ahead and see if they're still in there. Look at this, guys. Look at how gorgeous this is. Oh my god. I gotta see this with clear skies. Let's just take a look at this. Oh my god. Look at the colors. Oh, it's so gorgeous. Oh my god, I am so flippin' excited to do this quest, guys. Like, I'm not even kidding. I am so freaking excited to do this quest line. But you know what? Today, I think we're gonna go ahead and end off today's episode right here. And next episode, we are going to pick up by heading to Amber Creek and talking to Jarl Agnar. And we're gonna progress through this story, guys. We're gonna take our time with the story, obviously, and with the world of Falskar. But I am so freaking excited to see this, guys. So, if you guys enjoyed this, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe for more daily videos, and if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter at CouchPotato1898. And guys, the adventures start next episode.